In this video, I will show you how to sum numbers by quarter in Excel like this. So let's get started. I have some transactions with dates and amounts in this Excel sheet. Now I want to calculate the total amount by quarter. For example, for the second quarter of the year, I want to sum these two amounts, and for the third quarter of the year, I want to get the sum of these three amounts. To get the sum by quarters, I will add one column at the end to store the quarter number of the dates. I will use the roundup function along with the month function to calculate the quarter number of the year. The roundup function, as the name suggests, rounds the number up to a specified number of decimal places. This function accepts two arguments, the number we want to round up and the number of digits to round up. If the second number of digits argument is 0, the number is rounded up to the nearest integer. Let's start the formula by typing an equal sign in the target cell. Now type roundup followed by an opening bracket. Let's extract the month number from the date using the month function. I will divide the month number by 3, and that will become the first argument of the roundup function. Type a comma and then type 0 as the second argument to get the quarter numbers as integers. Type the closing bracket of the roundup function. Here, the division operation will return a number between 0.33 for January and 4 for December. For example, for January, the month number will be 1, and when we divide 1 by 3, we get 0.33. The 0.33 value will be rounded up to 1, and that is the quarter number for January. Similarly, for November, the month number will be 11, and when we divide 11 by 3, we get 3.66. The 3.66 value will be rounded up to 4, and that is the quarter number for November. Hit the Enter key to complete the formula. Copy the formula to other cells by dragging the cell down from the bottom right corner of the cell. As you can see, we now have quarter numbers for all the dates. I will use the Excel SUMIFS function to sum numbers by quarters. The SUMIFS function returns the sum of the values in a range that meets multiple criteria. We can specify more than one pair of range and criteria using this function. Let's type an equal sign in the target cell to start the formula. Now type SUMIFS followed by an opening bracket. Since we want to sum the amount, let's select the range of the cells containing the amount as the first argument. Type a comma and then select the range of the cells containing the quarter numbers as the criteria range argument. Since I want to compare the quarter number of the dates with the quarter number given in the E column, I will select the quarter number of the E column as the third criteria argument. Type the closing bracket of the SUMIFS function. I will also make the amount and quarter range references absolute using the dollar signs like this, so that they will not change when we drag the formula to other cells. Hit the Enter key to complete the formula. Copy the formula to other cells by dragging the cell down from the bottom right corner of the cell. As you can see, we now have the sum of numbers by quarter of the year. We can also use the SUMPRODUCT function to get the sum by quarter numbers of the dates. If we use this approach, we do not need the helper column to calculate the quarter that we used earlier. Here is the formula that uses the SUMPRODUCT function to sum numbers by quarter of the year. This part of the formula extracts the quarter numbers from the dates as earlier. It returns an array of 7 elements containing the quarter number of each date. The elements are then compared with the quarter we have stored in the E column. This comparison also returns an array of 7 elements containing true and false values. the true value is returned if the quarter of the date is equal to the quarter of the year mentioned in the E column. Otherwise, it returns a false value. I have then multiplied this array with the amount array, and this boolean multiplication operation converts true and false values to 1 and 0 respectively. When these two arrays are multiplied, only the amount having the same quarter number will be multiplied with 1, and the rest of the amount will be multiplied by 0, thus becoming 0. For example, the first date is the only date that belongs to quarter 1. So the first element of the array is the first amount, and rest of the array elements are 0. Similarly, for the second quarter, only the second and third elements will contain the amount. The rest of the array elements will be 0. Finally, the sum product function will add these amounts together, and that will be the sum of the amounts by quarter. I will make the amount and date range references absolute using the dollar signs so that when I drag the formula to other quarters, they do not change. Let's copy the formula to other cells by dragging the cell down from the bottom right corner of the cell. As you can see, we now have the sum of numbers by quarter of the year. Watch these videos for more Excel tips, tricks, and how-to tutorials. If you found this video helpful, please like the video and subscribe to our channel.